Time, 6:03 p.m., January 2nd of 42. It's the beginning of the new year, and trouble's already brewing. I had hoped that the new year would bring a fresh start, but instead my files are loaded down with new cases. My old gal left me in shambles, and the new one, Jane, is hassling me to settle down. She's as much trouble as the last, seems they all are. My mind's like an old jalopy, shot. I'm Mace Rocket, I'm Rocco for God's sake. I can shake this.
Hey, Rocco.
Wait, no, what are you doing here? Get out.
Wait, I need your help.
I dealt with Tracy for 2 years of my life. Once the job started pulling me away, she changed. In general, the broad went nuts.
All right, no funny business.
Who's this?
It's not who we're talking about. Sit down.
She's pretty.
Why are you here?
Right, you remember Susan?
Susan? The one that came to our soirees?
Exactly. I was supposed to meet up with her earlier for lunch this week, and she never showed. Nobody's seen her for a while.
Well, where was she last seen?
I'm not quite sure, but I know that she had a date the night before I was supposed to meet up with her, and she'd never met him before.
You thinking he may have done something to her?
I was hoping you would tell me.
I don't know much about this case, but I knew it was going to be a crazy ride.
Is this the place we're supposed to meet?
No. Come on. This is it. We were supposed to meet here at noon.
Did you know anything about the guy?
I didn't know she was going on a date. She never told me anything.
Was she on anyone's bad side?
She seemed like a nice gal.
Did you hear anything suspicious?
Not at all.
Dear Jane, I'm gonna be late again. I know it's been every day this week. I'm sorry, there's something about this one that's troubling me. I'm sorry, Jane. I'll be home right when I'm through.
Hey, Rocco, I have something...
Can't, I'm busy.
I know.
Yeah, this case you gave me is nuts.
That's what I'm trying to say. I think I may have some information that you'd like.
What are you talking about?
I don't want to tell you over the phone. How about we meet at my house for drinks?
Fine, 2 will work.
Sounds perfect. See you then.
Susan!
Hey, Rocco! How have you been?
How have you been? Where have you been?
I've been on vacation. Sorry I didn't tell you. I really didn't tell anyone.
Tracy was worried sick about you.
Tracy was the only one that knew. I figure I should tell her since we were supposed to have lunch. She said it sounded fun. Did she say something else?
See you around.
What can I say? I was made for a fool. I didn't trust my gut, and going to her house was only gonna rub my face in it again.
So how have things been going?
Would I be here if I had good news?
I would hope so. Do you want me to make you something?
Coffee. Coffee's fine.
Nothing stronger?
Like I said, coffee. Trace, what exactly did you call me here for? Yesterday I ran into Susan.
Seem a little upset. Have you still not talked to Jane?
Why did you call me here?
You know, I would always call you back.
Why did you call me here, Tracy? I didn't come here to talk about the case. I came here to talk about you. I know that you lied. I ran into Susan.
And what'd she say?
She told me that you knew all along, that she was on vacation. There is no case.
Is that so?
You have to understand that we have nothing. Whatever we have is gone, and I'm with someone else now. Look, you nutcase, I...
How long has it been since you've seen Jane? 2, maybe 3 days? It's a long time, don't you think?
Where is this my garage?
I hope you don't mind I borrowed your spare.
Jane, what are you doing here? Tracy, what's going on?
Susan and I met up, it must have been a month or so before she went missing, and that's when I first heard about Jane. Jane this, and Jane and Rocco that. Susie said it seemed you finally moved on, even heard there may be wedding bells in your future. And so, of course, I knew it was my time to step in. It wasn't going to be easy, though. You'd always been so stubborn. You'd always been so into your work.
And so you did this?
I'm not finished. There's one thing that I didn't understand, though. I didn't understand why you'd choose to be tied to this hussy rather than me. That's when it hit me. You'd been using Jane to show me how I'd blown it. By getting a little nutty over your job, I mean. Really, could you blame me, though? You're such a catch.
I'm not trying to show you anything, prove anything. Susan's right, I moved on.
You can't honestly say that you and I spent all that time just working together. That you wouldn't choose me over her.
Tracy, you're already chosen. Just don't hurt her. She doesn't even mix up in this.
You came to your senses. I still don't see why you care what happens to her. Seems you just made me out to be a complete dimwit.
Tracy, I...
Shut up!
Tracy, stop! Tracy, what are you doing? Tracy, what is that? What are you doing?
You made your choice. She is pretty.
Jane, what did you do, you crazy?
You made your decision, not me. You made your choice.
I tremble at your touch. I know I shouldn't, but that's the way it is. I want you oh so much. I know I shouldn't, but that's the way it is. I can see so clearly that we are worlds apart. But oh, when you are near me, I can see beyond my heart. I worship at your shrine. You said I shouldn't, but that's the way it is. I begged you to be mine, I said I wouldn't.